me reacting to that video, really. Hello guys, and welcome back to yet another reaction and analyzation of me to the max. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a young music producer, and with this series I'm trying to get outside of my usual music taste, and I'm trying to listen out for music I usually don't listen to, so that I can learn something from my own music, but also that I can bring you some knowledge of maybe your favorite bands that you have not known before yet. In the recent videos I have covered a lot of Ghost, and today we are back at it again with another Ghost song, and this one has been recommended by you in nearly every video now. Every second comment I got was about Cirice, and today it's the day. Today we're listening to that one. I'm really looking forward to it. And it seems to be the longest song so far that I've listened to. I'm really looking forward to it, and I hope I can really take everything apart, because with long songs, it's sometimes really hard to keep an overview, especially after the first listening. So let's get right into it.
I can feel the thunder that's breaking in your heart. see that you're lost without me. I can feel the thunder. I can feel the thunder that's breaking in your heart. I can see through the scars inside you. I can feel the thunder that's breaking in your heart. I can see through the scars inside you. I can feel the
oh my god, that was awesome. And I don't even know what was better, the music or the video, but both of them were really, really great. And I think the music video was very fun to look at, and props to the kid actors, because usually kid actors are really terrible, but in this one it was quite good, especially for a music video. I liked what they were going at with it, and yeah. Once again, it's these kind of bands that I like the most, that don't only want to bring out music as an entertainment value, but where you can really feel that there's a little bit more behind it, that there's more behind the lyrics and more behind what they want to say, and that shows in the music video. You know, it's not just a standard performance video, even though they are somewhat performing. It's not them, of course, it's some kids that are taking the roles, but even though it is that, there's still a story around it, you know, that it's like a school talent show. And yeah, I'm currently still making up my mind what the video really wants to play into, but I think there's a couple of themes going on here. You know, back in the days when all of the old school doom metal really started taking off, it was against God, and nobody was allowed to listen to that. And then there were big events where students were even burning CDs from metal bands and stuff like that. I think it's playing into that, that when the music came up, it was kind of, everybody was scared of it, and you should not be listening to it, and stuff like that. It's really fun to watch this video, and it was a very enjoyable song. I especially liked the main riff a lot. The main riff reminded me a lot of doom metal. Comparatively, the whole song was, musically speaking, very simple, and I think it's one of the simpler songs that I've heard so far, but that doesn't make it any worse, you know. I'm repeating myself here with that line, but simple doesn't mean that it's bad music. Simple means pretty much that it's, or when you are able to make a whole song that is 6 minutes with just one simple idea, that just proves the point to me anyways, that that simple idea is really, really great, and that is hard. So, yeah, I want to go into the analyzation of it and see what I can pick up on. All right. That's definitely an acoustic guitar. I think there's some piano coming in around here. Yeah.
We're going to be late.
Now it sounds like they are mixing the acoustic guitars with electronic guitars already. Especially on the right side, you can hear it. And there's a little bit of overdrive going on. Yeah, so the left side is still the acoustic guitar and the right side is a slightly overdriven guitar. Yeah, this is like old school doom metal, but really heavy and really dark. This is really heavy. Like, I think this is the most headbanger song I've heard so far from Ghost. And it really surprises me because not only did they respect their style, but they still do something new with it. And I think what really makes a difference here is the drummer sticking to a very simple beat. On the floor, pretty much. It's a seemingly slow song, and the guitar riff definitely also helps with it. The guitar riff actually reminds me a little bit of like an industrial riff, because there's a lot of palm muted guitars, and it's repeated relatively quickly, the whole riff. It's not too long, and the palm mutes are that could be out of an industrial song, really. What's also interesting is the bass. It's only playing the notes on the hits of the kick and the snare drum, which kind of gives the whole song a bit more of a pulsating vibe, because the bass only comes in when the kick hits the floor. That gives it a really heavy marching vibe. We still haven't left the main melody, the main riff from the guitars. It's a it's the exact same thing that we hear from the beginning in the introduction, just that we have introduced some palm mutes in between, and it's swapped over to overdriven guitars instead of just being acoustic guitars. Also in this part you can hear a little bit of strings going on in the background, but very slight. Yeah, they're very slight. The guitars sound like there's a bit of quad tracking going on. We definitely have two guitars on each side that are very upfront, that are having all the characteristics, that are just, you know, like having all the small details in them. But I think there's two more tracks laid under those, because otherwise you wouldn't have that full smooth sound of the overdrive. We'll be right back. love that those two parents are completely infatuated with the music, and that these are also the only characters that really love it. Maybe these are supposed to be the parents of the guys that are performing, of the kids that are performing, but I'm not sure. But I love those two. These are my favorite. Even though you've been told so, can you hear the rumble? This chord progression right here, or this change of chords, this is so ghostish. I have heard it nearly in every ghost song now. I don't know exactly what it is, but this is the ghost feeling of... Can you hear the rumble? Wait. Even though you've been told so, can you hear... So, I've been analyzing this part now for, I guess, about 15 minutes, going back and forth on what I think about it, and I just want to get it right, so I don't want to just tell you guys something, just that I have said anything to it. I want to give you a little bit of value. So what I think here is that we do not have a real key change, but what we have is a change of scales. In this part, for the majority of the main chords, we are either in like a melodic minor and a Lydian minor, so some mixolydian stuff going on in here, where they mix together different scales, and in this case, different notes that seem very darkish, right? That kind of reminds you of the Devil's Triad and stuff like that. This is going on for the main riff. And then they are changing into a relatively major sounding scale compared to what they have done before, which makes the bridge, where we just have the piano and Tobias singing, seem a lot more upbeat and a lot happier, a lot more resolving. And then it goes back to their own melodic minor, Lydian minor, something mixolydian scale. And that really makes the magic of this part happening. So let's listen to it, and I will point you out when happens what. Hello, you've been told so. Change to the major scale, relative. No, that's the bridge. And so what I just wanted to point out at that point also is just the production value of the vocals. It's astonishingly simple, with a little bit of reverb echo on the main vocals and then some background vocals on the left and the right side, but it's just very tasteful and very well balanced. So it doesn't smother over anything. You can still very clearly hear the words he's saying and what he's singing about, and I love that. I can see through the scars inside you. I can feel the thunder that's breaking in your heart. I can see through the scars. And now we change back to their own scale. I also, just to point it out, I love the like the cheesiness and the silliness of this music video. It's really, I think it reminds me a lot of the music video to From the Pinnacle to the Pit, where it is funny enough to look at and cheesy enough so that you can shrug it off, but you can also take it seriously. Can you hear the thunder? Can you hear the thunder that's breaking? Now there is nothing between us. From now our work is eternal. Can't you see that? This is really the the epitome of you won't understand the music, but your kids will love it. Can't you see that you're lost without me? What a cool transition. So we have a dropout. See that you're lost. Can't you see that you're lost without me? And then we have reversed percussion elements that you normally think would line up with where the rest of the instruments come back in, but actually the break extends beyond that. Can't you see that you're lost without me? And the without me stands alone in the room, and then everything else comes back. I can feel the thunder that's breaking in your heart. And I think now we're back to the scale that we had in the bridge before, where we just had Tobias singing and the now it just extends beyond that idea of that more major part. Also, I think it's a very interesting choice to put the shot of somebody going completely nuts on the piano, on the synthesizer there, when there's no synthesizer at all. There's just nothing happening. Yeah. Really settling in this whole Antichrist, doom metal vibe with the church, like church organ sound. Can't you see that you're lost without me? We have the same transition now again with the without me and the reverse percussion elements ending up before you actually think they should end up. Stop. You know what I mean, right? I can feel the thunder that's breaking. What's going on with that guy? I was wondering before what's happening to him. That doesn't look healthy. I can see through the scars inside you. Also, in the recent videos, I haven't really been talking a lot about how incredible of a singer Tobias is, but it really is insane, and it especially shows here. Me reacting to that video, really. That was insane. I don't know what it is about them. Maybe let's have a little talk about the music so far, because now I have been listening to a good amount of their songs, and I feel like now it's a good time to maybe talk a little bit about why I like them, because usually I just point out the very technical stuff and, you know, the kind of vibes that they're going for, but I think in general, what I have talked about in the beginning of the video, it's that you can really feel like they do music as a piece of art, that they understand it fully and they embrace all points of it, not only the musical side, but also the artistic, also pretty good freeze frame. Let's go back to somewhere else. And what I love about it, it's scratching a bit of nostalgia here and there when they are referring to old doom metal, which I really like. And it also is a little bit resemblant. It's a little bit like Queen from time to time. They have really nice melodies. They have a very simple way of writing their music. It is distinguishable from all the other bands out there. You can always know that it's a Ghost song when you hear it. And yet, it's always interesting with every new song. They don't really repeat themselves, but they repeat themselves with what they are doing. Just that they do it in very different ways. And I don't know, it always seems like they have something interesting to tell. And you can really feel that there's like a true, authentic something behind the music. And that's what I really appreciate when, you know, it's not just empty singing into the wild, but that there's actually some kind of weight behind what they're doing. And I love them for that, you know, because what I sometimes really dislike about, just as an example and a little excourse about modern pop, is that it is very happy and very upbeat, which is not a problem in itself, but that it's not authentic. That it's talking about such mundane topics that feel so, I don't know, like so worthless if you really think about them. Just euphoric moments in your youth, or oh my god, I have been at a really cool party lately and it was so great. And it's like that kind of stuff just doesn't really connect with me, and I can't take it serious, and I can't really feel the authenticity behind that. But with this, it's different. It's motivating in a way that is deeper than just surface level things and events that happen to you in your life. It's a more deeper story, and I like that. And it really feels like they want to lift you up. They don't just do that because, oh, I want to write a song that is uplifting. No, they have something uplifting to tell you. And yeah, I think that really makes me connect to this band a lot. I have covered the musical finesse and also the production already without going over the song twice. And I think that's it for Cirice. I don't know how to pronounce that really. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I really, really loved that song, and I think this one will go onto my favorites playlist. I'm stoked to listen to more songs of them, but also you guys that recommend me all of the Ghost things. How about you recommend me something outside of Ghost? What else do you guys listen to? What else do you guys think is music that I would connect to, or that just you connect to, that you think is a great band that maybe not everybody knows about? Or what are the reasons why you listen to that? Let me know in the comments. And also, share your opinion about Ghost. Like, I really want to know beyond, you know, like, oh, they have a cool sound. I really want to know what makes you guys stick with them. Is it their characters, like who they are behind the stage? Because now that I've listened to some of the music videos, I get recommendations on YouTube of like behind the scenes and backstage videos from Ghost where they are being silly. But I have not looked into that yet because I don't want to take away the fun before not knowing them enough. So I will see about that. Also, I don't want to get spoiled for potential music videos or you know, like live performances of songs that I've not heard before. But yeah, really, let's take this video as a milestone of, let's go back and review what we have had so far with Ghost, and just tell me, guys, what you think about them, why you are connected to them, why you love their music. I would really appreciate that. Anyways, let's end this video and I hope you stay safe.